Greg, disappointing way to lose 10 minutes from the end there. Would 1-1 have been about fair?
Yeah, definitely. They didn't really create any chances in the second half. First half, they had a few, but nothing that really causes any problems. Obviously, a few mistakes from us today, but it happens in football, and we just got to move on and hopefully get a win next game.
You looked well back in the game once you'd got level. They probably got on top early on after they'd scored, but good resilience from you to get that equaliser just before the break. And then it looked like you might really kick on, but it just didn't really happen. You didn't really have a clear-cut chance that you thought, right, we should have scored that.
No, we didn't, but as I said again, and I'll say it, it's mistakes in football that cost you games, but obviously the lads know now, and obviously there's a lot of heads down in the changing room, but it shows that we care and it shows that it means something to us. But obviously, again, we've just got to kick on and hopefully get a result next game, because there were some good positives today from the game.
And you got the sponsors vote as man of the match. Nice to get a bit of personal recognition for your performances.
Yeah, it is. It's great. But obviously, I'm here to do a job for the lads, and obviously, it's great for me to get that. But I'd rather do well for the team than just for myself, to be honest.
And Solihull flying at the minute, 6 wins out of 7, and you can perhaps see why. They don't give a lot away, and they've stuck really 2 of their few chances away when they did come along.
Yeah, exactly. They're a good, strong, powerful team, to be honest. They've got a few big lads, and obviously Darren Byfield has got a lot of experience with his playing championship and things like that. But we should have at least got something from the game today. A point would have been brilliant, because obviously they're on a great run, but something obviously that we've got to learn from.
And Darren Byfield, like you say, for an unfamiliar player at left back, must have been a challenge for you.
Yeah, it was. Obviously, he knows what he's doing, his experience, he knows how to get on his shoulder and stuff like that. But I thought I dealt with him alright, to be honest. And still got legs to say how old he is. But yes, it was a good test for me today.
Are you enjoying your loan spell? It's finished actually after today, your first month. Now all eyes switched to see whether you come back again. But you've sort of just established yourself now these last 2 games, and like we say, perhaps in an unfamiliar position.
Yeah, I'll play anywhere for the team, to be honest, as long as I'm getting football and getting my fitness back up. But it was disappointing not to play a couple of weeks ago and 2 losses, but it's football, and obviously I just kept my head down and done alright these last 2 games. But I'd love to stay here, to be honest, just to get games, because Notts are on a great run at the moment with 11 unbeaten, so it'd be hard for me to get into the team, but I'd like to stay.
And filed next week if you are here. 9 straight league wins as league leader, so it doesn't get any easier for you. But perhaps the expectations are going to be lifted next week, so yes, you can perhaps go out with a bit of freedom.
Yeah, exactly. Just got to go out there and just show them what we can do, because we can beat teams like that. And as you've seen today, they're on a run, and we should have beat them. So it doesn't matter what opposition you come against, bottom or top of the league, you've always got to go into the game thinking you're going to win.
And we've got to mention it, what happened last week, obviously going in goal when Sam got sent off. You've had a few headlines this week. Just an impulse thing when the red card came out?
Yeah, it's just obviously we talked about it in the week, which was weird, and then what are the chances of that happening, and then obviously I went in goal, so it was good for me and good adrenaline rush, and good to get on the pitch and play in goal again, which was weird, so yeah, it was good.
And perhaps your loan spell might be extended as goalkeeper, because Sam's now starting a 3-game ban. Lincoln City have got a cup replay, so it looks like Paul Farman's tied up. So the manager's going to be on the lookout for a new number one for the next 3 weeks.
Well, as you say, anything can happen in football. So I don't know, it definitely won't happen, but obviously I would do a job for the team if it came around to something like that again.